Ratos e foram. How's your week? Thank you, Peter. Very well, very well. Glad that the weekend is finally here. Final pushes today, and we go relax. Yeah, that's fantastic. To be honest, this week for me was not the best one. Personal trading. Well, the yen pairs did provide some fantastic moves. Okay, Aussie also, but mainly the market was kind of setting up the setups, right? Because you're not trading 5 minute or 1 minute. It takes time to for the setups to develop, basically. So it is kind of testing your patience sometimes if you're mid-term trader, not very, very short-term scalper. But it pays off at the end of the day, so why not? Oh, Mandar, very glad to hear that. I hope that you're going to enjoy it. Well, Peter, we do have such periods, right? It's part of the business. We can't w win them all. It's just important for you to not go down mentally and move on. That's it. All right, Mandar, for you and the other new guys which I'm seeing here for the first time. Let me just tell you how these sessions are going, guys. During the week, we do hold live rooms where we discuss setups, live opportunities, basically anything that we are going to be trading and following during the week. On Fridays, the session that you have with me, my name is Jordan again. We're going over our strategies that we're using in the club. Okay, besides the manual trading, the software strategies. And we show what is the best way and the best setups to trade these strategies the way we do it? Okay, the way that has proven us over the years for some of them that it works, and basically all the little details and tricks that you should know and understand when you're trading these strategies. So let's start, guys. Peter, I keep forgetting you're a veteran trader. By the way, thank you very much for the book. Appreciate that. All right, so those are the results. As you can see, not the best, not the worst overall performance for the week. Plus 3.5% almost, which is more or less great. Broken down into the strategies, Triple B best performer this week. We have 2.5% there. Libra Gold minus one, SRS plus one, Crystal Ball minus one, Divergence University, tiny loss minus 0.15% or so. So I count it as break even here. Gemini plus 1% and Scorpio close to plus 1% as well. So more or less, we're above 3% mark for this week. Again, not the best, not the worst. As long as we're making profits, that's what counts. Another week, another battle won. At least for me on my side. If you end up the week without losing or maybe even making money, no need for regrets. Or as Peter said, I'm over the short-term emotional fluctuations, so yeah, I've started reading it. Yes, we have extremely busy periods at the moment, and it's gonna be like this at least for the next 2, 3 months. So going with it slowly. Yes, exactly. All right, so let's start with the SRS guys. The week did begin since the 4th, right? Today is the 8th. So anything for this one right here. One trade. Okay. Winning 1%. So why not? If it's not there, we are not going to force it. Okay. Quickly, guys, for those of you who don't know what SRS Trend Rider represents and does, it is a trend trading strategy. It does work, the entries do work with trend lines. And the one thing that we're looking, actually, two things we're looking for in the trend lines is this. So let's say this is your trend line, right? What we would like to see is A, B, C, D, or 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 to be above 2 when we're looking to sell. Okay, then we connect 1 and 3, and we're looking for the sell setup right here with the breakout. Another important thing to mention is that we would like to see the distances between 1, 3, and the breakout to be as close, not as close, but as equal as possible. We're not measuring it by the pip, we just want to see them visually equal. And we had a very good example with the dollar yen, I believe, earlier this week. So if you didn't watch the previous live rooms, you might want to go ahead and check out this specific example in the previous videos from this week and just see the discussion about it there live. So that's generally the setup we're looking for when selling. Of course, if we do get divergence between these two highs, that's perfect. And then the other setup, which is rarely appearing, but it does appear, is the one example that we have live today. And that's the double double, which basically plays with the distances. So we have two distances very close to each other, all right, and one big gap in between. So that's more or less what we got in this example. Closer distances right here and one bigger gap in between. That usually is going to remind us special cycles. Okay, it has more or less the same structure. However, in that case, we didn't have another spike here, all right, in order to provide here a different leg on its own. It was just spike down and then continuation. So again, that's the double double. Eurozy, looking for sell setups. This is where we got the entry, and this is where we got the targets. By the way, for the buys, we have the vice versa. All right, just so you guys have an idea how it works. We want to have the 1, 2, 3, 4 in the opposite direction. Okay, 4 is below 2, which means we must have lower lows. All right, something like that is not a trend line. We must break below the previous low in order to call it ABCD or then a valid trend line. Okay, so same rules apply, just vice versa. So that's about SRS this week, one trade. Moving on to Triple B, where we had more trades. All right, we actually need to scroll back to the previous page. That's the first one, pound yen. What was the score here? Triple B, 2.5. All right, let's see what we had, guys. Pound yen, buy setup. We said that during the week, based on the daily cycles, we were looking for the buy opportunities. So how does Triple B work? Let me just zoom in a bit. Triple B is entirely based on Bollinger Bands. Okay, so what we do is we take the Bollinger Bands from two time frames. The window that you're going to see in the middle right here is actually showing us the higher time frame. It gives us a preview of the higher time frame. The bars, okay, these tiny bars right here, and the slope of 20 MA. So the idea is very simple, guys. We check out the position of the price on the higher time frame, whether it is above the 20 MA or below it. And we also check the slope of the 20 MA. So once the price is above it, above 20 MA, and the slope of 20 MA is going upwards, we can drop to the lower time frame, and then we would like to see the price giving us double waves and coming inside the opposite band. Right, so if we have upward move on the 4-hour chart, bars are here. What we are waiting for is any type of double wave corrections pushing towards the opposite side of the bands, and this is where we're looking to attack buys. Right, so all that is given to you by the software. The only thing that you need to check is the slope. All right, if you have already developed slope, because sometimes the price is going to 20 MA is going down, you have price moving down, 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 quick spikes above it, and then continuation. All right, so in order to avoid buys in this situation, because the main direction is still down, we're checking the slope of 20 MA, which means if the slope turns up, we have most likely a reversal, because the 20 MA is lagging. It gives you the information based on the last 20 candles, right? In reality, that's what the moving average does, averaging the last 20 candles. So if the slope moves up, it means that the price is more or less reversing, or at least it has short-term bullish momentum, and it's not just spiking above 20 MA and then continuing lower. So that's basically the idea of Triple B, guys. Of course, one of the most important things for us is to look for double wave correction pattern, and not just one straight leg moving down and then you want to attack it. Okay, so double waves going at the opposite band, and then you're looking for the buys. Of course, same goes for the opposite, moving down, prices below on the lower time frame. You want for the price to go to the opposite bands in double waves, and then you're attacking for the sells. That's a long conversation, Peter. It could be used, but that's just how Vlad designed the system. Yeah, I mean, we can literally apply 1,000 things here, and there could be literally 1,000 applications of anything you can think when it comes to trading, right? So I don't have a specific clear question. Maybe you can ask Vlad about it. But that's how he saw it, he designed it, tested, it worked, so he stuck to that. Thanks for the question. All right, so the first thing that we have is pound yen. That's the 4-hour chart on the higher time frames. All right, we're looking for buy setups. And this is where we got double wave correction, attacking the buys, risk reward not bad. We are looking for up moves. Perfect. Now, before I switch to the next slide, next picture, let's go ahead and cover the other two that we had here. What do you think about this setup, guys? Is that a valid double wave? That's number two. Okay, that's number one. Is that a valid setup? Sideways trend, I could agree. And also, here, we kind of broke above it. Maybe even if we call it a double top, then yes, I would be willing to more or less trade this setup. But then, the risk reward is kind of too much for me. And I know that pound yen is already coming to the zones where we said we were looking for the reversals. If it was in the beginning of the trend, and I know that we have the initial push up, very strong one, all right, so we have tiny pullback, something like that, ugly. Can we call that ascending? No, it's in a ugly range. But I'm willing to take the risk because this is the beginning of the trend, all right? And I know that I have at least, I don't know how many pips above me. But in the situations where we know we're coming closer to levels very soon that we are starting to look for the sells, is that worth the risk with such a big stop loss? Not sure, guys. Not for me. Okay? Next one, right here. Does that look like double wave? Yeah, ugly one, but we might say it is. However, when we look closer at these two candles, we find out that this entire move is stuck inside it. All right? So, if we're going to trade such things, it will be very, very, very aggressive. Not a real healthy pullback. However, the risk reward is very seductive here. Okay, because you know, even if you're scalping for the opposite band, which is the short term targets, okay, yes, you might go ahead and do it, but only because of the risk reward. If the risk reward was like that and the stop loss, I wouldn't touch it at all. And then, of course, you have the two candles rule, which is aggressiveness. The only way I'm going to ignore the two candles rule, override it somehow, is if I actually get a double wave like that inside this range. Right, so if this is the 15 minute chart, when you drop to the 5 minute chart and you see a double wave, then we can say, all right, maybe that was a pullback. But if you have, let's say something like that, two candles here and one straight move, and it ended it here, right, before breaking it. Not healthy, not good. All right, interesting ideas here on this one. So I hope we're moving forward with our knowledge, guys. Again, we have another situation right here. We pushed up, all right, and then the price started correcting. And this is where it becomes tricky, once again. Right? All this move up and down stuck inside these two candles. So can we go ahead and fit inside anything else? Again, kind of hard because these candles are very big. It's just not clear. Do we want to fight it? Not sure. Alright? So that's our pound yen by now, moving forward, because we have plenty of trades. Pound cut, again, buy idea. Where is our, right here. That's basically the double wave that we have. All right, and this is where we are attacking the buys. Now here, the risk reward starts to improve a bit because 20MA is moving up and the green rectangles are actually showing us where the 20MA is, okay, and how much distance we have towards that. On the previous move, right here, actually, yeah, we do have some sort of double wave. That was right at the opening of the week, so we didn't catch it. But anyway, it was there, so more or less a valid setup, okay? This one pushed lower after it pushed here for the short-term targets. Maybe collected, maybe not, not sure. But the longer term was not there. Price reversed, stop loss hit. Pound yen after the pushes, okay? No, or that's before it. I believe that's before that, guys. Oh no, that's the 1 hour chart, sorry. That is the 1 hour chart, which means in that situation, and that's a perfect example. You see, 4 hour chart combination with a 15 minute chart gave us the buys already, right here. since the very beginning, I believe. Daily, with the 1 hour chart still pushing lower, right? This is the daily chart here, the white window. Still bearish momentum. 1 hour chart is now, well, of course, in that case, risk reward too big. But here, it starts to make more sense because we're coming closer to the 20 MA. We're coming closer to all the levels that we know should provide us with the pullbacks, at least, or maybe even the continuation lower that we're looking for. We can also fit cycles inside this move. Okay, that could be 161 double wave. That could be something like that as well for a special cycle later on. Even though it wouldn't be perfect because I like these two legs to be more or less equal. All right, and since I can't really count on this one because we don't have a healthy correction here, it's more or less the bigger wave. Doesn't really matter. The idea is that we do have the wave up. We do have the risk reward on our side now. It starts to look very, very interesting. And this is where we can actually start and look for short-term scalps, guys. Boom, we quickly collect at the opposite band and make a few pips, okay? Aussie yen, that was the push up, okay, while still holding to the upside. And that's what I told you during the live rooms. It's not the only way to look for buys when it comes to trend lines. All right, we were discussing that, and I think there was. Oh, Aussie pushing. Fantastically. I really hope you're involved, guys. Did you manage to catch this one? Right here, as we explained. Step trading. I really hope you got in. Anyway, the buy idea here before this massive push to the downside, which we definitely love. Yeah, nice. Is right here. We had the uptrend line. Okay. And this is what we explained. During these pushes lower, we're expecting for the price to go ahead and reach the top zones right here. So, very short term, we might be expecting for the price to push again. If you don't find yourself a trend line, this is not the only way to trade it, guys. Hidden divergence was given, coming closer to the trend line. Perfect. And this is where you have the idea of triple B. All right. For instance, it gave us double wave first time to a big distance. Okay. And the trend line was not yet reached. You know you have a trend line. You know the 20 MA is still far away. So wait for it. Okay. Then this double wave turns into a bigger cycle. So that's basically leg number one. Boom, we get the price lower. We go closer to the 20 MA, to the trend line. And now the distance between 20 MA and the current market price is shrinking, which means the risk reward is improving. And now this trade starts to make sense. Okay, just patience. That's all. So basically that's the attack. And by the way, if you see that, you could have been even a bit more patient because price actually pushed lower, and every time the price pushed lower and it closed above the 20, above the band, the opposite band here, that would have been a signal. So more patience means even better risk reward, even better entry price. All right. And then you got the push to the upside and we're shooting for the long-term target, which is the opposite band, and we collected. Okay. So that's why the cycles and the live rooms are extremely important together with the reports. Okay, because we have short-term direction, which tells you, all right, short-term buys are more or less acceptable at that stage. Then once you reach level X, you can start looking for the sells. Or if you don't find a setup, at least cash out and protect your capital, right? Because there is a very good chance we're going to bounce from there. Okay. What do you mean entry point now? Are you asking me where to sell? Sales at the moment are not good. We want to sell pullbacks and not when the price is moving lower. So basically any pullback for me is an opportunity to sell while we're moving towards the bottom of this channel. Okay, and maybe even if we break below it, channel or flag, all right, for us to go ahead and continue up until here somewhere. So pullbacks and sells. All right, Aussie dollar, buy opportunity. We know that the price was moving up. 20MA is right here. All seems perfect. We did get this triple cycle. Finally, very good risk reward, in my opinion. All right. And on the 4-hour chart, you can see how it looks. Peter, correct me if I'm wrong, but that does look like some sort of flag again here, right? So it just makes sense to go ahead and try for the buys. Okay, intraday cycle, 4-hour chart looks good. We have the momentum. And this is pure price action, guys. We spoke about that many, many times, and I'm going to repeat it again. Without any indicators, without anything else, all right, just imagine you just started trading Forex. What do you see? Fast push up. It took that many candles for this push up to develop and to go ahead and move that much. And then you have that much distance, which is almost 2 times, I believe, all right, horizontally. And it moved only 50% of what it previously moved to the upside. So what's the simplest conclusion we can draw here? Up move, correction. Nothing more than that, right? And why I love triple B is the reason because the 20MA from the higher time frame gives you room and space for spikes, and then the price might continue. Because if you're trading, let's say, I don't know, divergence or false break or breakouts, whatever, and you're jumping in at that stage, like 90% of the time you're going to place your stop loss here, which means if the price spikes and then moves up, you lose instead of making money, even though your analysis were right. Okay, and that's why triple B is fantastic, because protecting the higher time frame 20MA gives room for your trade to work. That's it. So buy opportunity. You see, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Spike, 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 spike below 20MA also. And only then it moved. So that's basically stop loss clearance, guys. Nothing more than that. There you go. This is your flag, and boom, then the continuation. So why lose money instead of making money? Anyway, so we pushed higher and we said that from these levels, now we can actually start looking for the sell opportunities once they are provided. Aussie franc, also buy idea here. Okay, that's the double wave we are looking at. Very good entry because we pushed very close to the 20MA once again. So I do love it. Okay. And this is where we started the attack for the buys. Unfortunately, it did push lower. Okay, and this time, no save by 20 MA on the 4-hour chart. We end up with a loss. All right, let's cover one more and then we move on to the other strategies. Pound over, buy opportunity. Now, this one is more or less pretty obvious and clear. 4-hour chart started the push up. By the way, guys, this is exactly what I was trying to explain in the beginning. You see how the dash that we see, that's the 20 MA, is pushing higher. Okay, so you know you have bullish trend. But then the price falls, breaks it right here. So technically speaking, I believe that's the moment where that happened. You're going to get sell signals. Just imagine that was a valid sell signal. So in that moment, you really don't want to be looking for sells. All right. That's why we're looking for the slow, because price action might be doing something for some reason, but we want to jump in only once the trend has actually switched to the opposite side. Perfect example. That's why the slope is important for us, in order to avoid those situations. Okay? So here we are, price pushing up, double wave correction, extremely good moment to jump in, because you're bouncing exactly from the 20 MA. Nothing more, nothing less. Even if that trade loses, it is by the book trade. Question, triple B is good in catching the end of two waves. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. The biggest indicators for flag, etc. is consolidation, not retracement. Aussie dollar is consolidation. Not sure I understand the difference. What's the difference between... Ah, okay, now I get it. Sorry, it's my English. So basically, consolidation is something like that. A retracement is something like this, right? Is that what you mean, Peter? Yeah, I think I got it then. Yes. All right. Thank you. So let's move on, guys, to the other strategies, because time is advancing. Forex Libra code. Okay, we only had one trade as well. Losing one. Okay, dollar cut buy. And this is basically where the attack started. Okay, you know our view that we are looking for the buys. So basically, some kind of double wave coming after two false breaks, trend line breakout. So something is starting to move up. First of all, this high was broken. Second of all, this high was broken. So two false breaks, trend line breakout, and some sort of reversal starting to be delivered on the 15-minute chart. We know that our idea is more or less bullish, okay? And this is where Forex Libra Code comes in play. What's the idea of Forex Libra Code, guys, for the newcomers? We want to see false breaks, and then these false breaks to create later on higher highs. So technically speaking, this is what we get. Move down, this low is false broken, price move starts to move up, and then the most recent high creates higher highs. Okay, so false break, higher highs. Once this setup happens, okay, we're looking for the retracement. And if the retracement is provided, we want to jump into buys and look for the buy opportunities. Okay? So that's exactly what happened here. Break above, tiny pullback, and we are looking for the buys, which unfortunately were not delivered. Price pushed lower, and this is where we hit the stop loss. So that's it for Forex Libra Code. Just one trade this week. DU Divergence University trades. Those are trades based entirely on divergences. So this is probably the, well, not the only strategy, but most of the times you will be seeing trades which are going against the report, simply because when it comes to divergences, the nature and the idea of divergences is to catch the very top or very bottom. What do I mean? Let's say the price is moving up. Okay, we are obviously in a bullish momentum. So this is where the divergence forms. And this is where the attack is going to happen, right? And generally speaking, for all other strategies, we would like to see lower lows created or hidden divergence created, initial move, triple special cycle, some sort of confirmation that the trend is reversed, that the trend is reversing or it has already reversed. Okay? Divergences, on the other hand, they are trying to catch the very top or very bottom. And that's why, that's the reason why the report is going to say we are looking for buys, because there is still no reversal signs. But if we go to good levels, let's say you have a resistance here coming also trend line, this is, let's say, 100% Fibonacci, etc., etc. That means you have good levels, and attacking the divergence is going to make a lot of sense. All right, so it comes before the actual confirmations, before this step is delivered, but that's how it works. Okay, so let's go ahead and cover all the stuff that we have. 0.5. Oil. You know that we are looking for sales. All right? And this is where the attack for oil comes in play, guys. Just exactly what we said. We had one false break here. Okay? First of all, second of all, we got a false break here, if I'm not wrong. And I remember correct, because I also don't see the image very well. What else do we have? First divergence created here on the MAs, sorry, on the histogram. MAs, no divergence yet. Still, it's kind of a double bottom at best, right? But this is where the bigger divergence is also getting into the game. Alright, so we have divergence on the short term leg. Alright, and we have divergence on the bigger leg. And that's why we start to believe there should be a zone. This is also 61.8. There should be a corrective move providing some sort of short term momentum to the upside. So that's where the second divergence comes in that case, right here. Alright, and I believe the idea of attacking in that case makes a lot of sense. All right. That doesn't change the fact that we're still looking for the sell opportunities. So any push to the upside, creating hidden divergence, double waves, triple B, whatever you have in mind is still there. But divergences, they catch this one. Now, the only way for the divergence to be inside the direction, the main direction, is hidden divergence. All right, so let's say you have this situation right here, and if confirmed on the lower time frame, you're going to look for sells. All right, so hidden divergences go with the trend. Regular divergences, they are looking for the reversals or the pullback moves. That's more or less in summary, guys. Pound Kiwi. Pound Kiwi. Beautiful attack. Okay. And let's go ahead and analyze it. We have a bigger cycle. We then have that could be read as a special one, first of all, or If you don't like the waves, it could be also seen as a double wave as well. They are both going to give us the same idea and the same direction and conclusion. What else do we have, guys? Is false break number one happened right here. And this is our false break number two. Now, the MAs are under divergence as well. Okay? So, bigger double wave, smaller cycle, divergence second, false break. Why not try the attack? Okay, that's the 4-hour chart. If it pushes, our target is even below this one right here. Okay. Yeah, exactly. And when I have double bottoms that come with false breaks, it's even more reliable for me. But they more or less fall into the same category. Double bottoms or false breaks with divergences are amazing, especially when combined with some sort of level, which is horizontal support resistances, Fibonacci's, anything you have in mind, trend lines. Divergences could be very, very tricky and risky if not traded the correct way. I mean, I know people who just see divergence, attack every single divergence. No, wait for the right ones, guys. You must have some sort of level confirmation. That's number one. If you have level confirmation, then the risk reward which divergences are providing are simply amazing. Okay? So the combination of levels and divergences is awesome. Simply awesome. Not really. Totolo, not really. Let me try to find it for you. You see, that's where the idea of the report comes in play. You have pound Kiwi, which says both short term. Okay, that means we don't have a clear cycle to rely on from the higher time frames, which in other words means, translated to simple English, we can trade both directions. Okay, and we better do it in the short term. That basically tells us, look for divergences and the direction of the divergence. So let's say this is your last divergence here. It means the pressure is now bullish. Okay, or the price is bouncing from the top with some sort of divergence again. It means the pressure is bearish if you don't have a cycle. When you do have a cycle on the higher time frames, you're going to see something like that. We are looking for buys, or we're looking for sells. And then you have an extra confirmation and explanation behind it. So let's say OZN is bearish in the long term. We want to sell rallies, but in the short term, rallies are acceptable. And this is how that's translated in reality. That's your cycles from the higher time frame. We do expect continuation lower. That's daily chart, all right? So that's why it says bearish long term. But when the price is bouncing from this bottom of the channel, when you have divergence with false break, all right, when you have all these signs telling you that we are most likely going to trade inside the channel or the range here, the flag, this is where the report is going to say, all right, short-term rallies are now acceptable because that's the moves that we want to trade. In the short term, look for the buys. And then once we get to the levels, again, we switch and look for the sells. Yes. Yes, Peter. So basically, that's how to read the reports, guys. Short-term and long-term. If the short term says we have the reasons to look for the buys, and you go to the chart, or if you don't see it or don't understand it, please go ahead, ask me, Vlad, anyone of the traders in the group. Senior traders are going to help you understand why the short term is bullish and the longer term is bearish. Okay? And also, if you go to OZN inside the watch list, you have a table, right, which is going to tell you the type of cycle and the direction. So if you click on this chart, it is supposed to open for you an image, okay, which is not opening for some reason on my side. But basically, you will be looking at the cycle we are going to trade, which is the longer term direction. And then in the short term, we have the pullbacks. All right. Let's see where we're pound kiwi by Aussie cut, losing trade. And well, let's admit that that was not the best opportunity for us. Well, technically speaking, that was a correction with a false break with this spike. And to be honest, I fall for the price action here. Okay. Why? Because the count is amazing, first of all. So we have a cycle, which is a level, first of all, right? We have it. Second of all, look left, guys. Look at this. That's fantastic. So we have second level, horizontal one. Then we have divergence between these legs. And we have divergence right here as well, which is better seen on the 1 hour chart. Okay. And the idea that this spike tried to go lower and the divergence is here is more than enough for me to start looking for the sales basically. All right. So this is where this attack came from. Even after the push, you can see that the price is still holding the divergence. And let's see actually the live chart. And after the second false break, which happened right here, okay, boom, it starts to move lower. Right, so if that happens and you get kicked on the first one, if the setup is still the same, if everything is still in place, go ahead, by all means, attack it for the second time. All right, I mean, look at that. It's simply amazing. All right, so everything falls in place to the same zone. If your stop loss is cleared by these stupid spikes up, second attack is definitely something to look for again. All right, so pound cut. You remember our idea here. We have the levels, we have the trend lines coming from the top. So basically coming again to a level zone. In that case, we don't have divergence on the MAs. We only have divergence on the histogram. A regular with continuing on the second leg. And this is where the attack comes. And it pushed immediately to the upside, collecting the stops. And that's basically how we end up with break even or very, very tiny loss. That's Divergence University. Now let's go ahead and cover Scorpio code. Okay, quickly. And we are going to call it a day, guys. I know no one likes to work a lot on Fridays, so how do we superimpose the MACD oscillator over the MACD histogram? It's just an indicator which is available to you inside the members area. Right, so just go to the members area, download section inside indicators. You're going to find it. It's called MACD 2 lines. You're welcome. Let's see Eurozy, sell opportunity. Okay. Now, again, what's the idea of Scorpio code, guys? We are looking for the direction based on these three time frames here. Okay. And depending on how many arrows are in agreement, so basically if we have two out of the three, we're going to have moderate setup when looking to sell. If we're looking to buy and we have only one bullish, this is going to give us aggressive setup because only one out of the three is in the direction which we're looking to trade. So in that situation, we have 4-hour chart bearish, weekly chart bearish, and we get a bearish setup. How do we get the bearish setup? We count Scorpios. These Scorpios are basically providing you with the information of where the price stopped, okay, and made corrections, basically giving you swing points. All right, so if you have a Scorpio, it means the software picked up a swing point. And the idea is pretty simple. You are looking for, again, ABCD pattern, and this time it's a bit easier because now you have Scorpios, which means you need to count four Scorpios up, okay, and then for you to get a signal, which means MFD indicator to switch and the price to start trading below it, and then you start looking for the attacks. Vice versa for the buys. If you have four dropping Scorpios, this is where you start looking for the buys once MFD switches and gives you the signal. Okay, so in that case, obviously we are looking for sales. 1, 2, 3, 4 Scorpios. Perfect. We are looking for the sell opportunities. And price did push lower. We missed the target by a few pips, unfortunately. But then we got saved right here with the trailing stop feature, which did not allow us to actually lose the entire amount. We more or less ended up with break even here, very, very tiny loss. Kiwi dollar, before the breakouts, basically looking still for buy opportunities. And that one is tricky, so let's go ahead and cover it in depth, guys. If we start counting for Scorpios, that's not really correct, right? Because this Scorpio is lower than the other one. And ABCD to be valid cannot be like that. Should be like this, right? So what's the idea here? Why did we jump into this buy? Simple. We take a look at the big leg. And when we do that, now it starts to make sense. 1, 2, 3, 4. MFD switches, we are looking for the buys at the pullbacks because the price jumped higher at the switch, so we needed the pullback. As simple as that. Alright, and after the push up, we make some good profits. Let's see, pound yen, third trade, looking for the sales, alright. Swing, which actually doesn't show us the Scorpio for some reason, but anyway, that's the idea. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth Scorpio is missing, and you know the rule that if the fourth Scorpio is missing, we can actually go ahead and confirm it with diamonds or action zones. Now, in this case, I'm not sure what happened here with the software. The images are not showing up correct. And you can see also the other Scorpios are missing. So maybe there was a Scorpio, maybe there wasn't, not sure. But either way, there was a diamond. So diamond is also a place where we can expect the price to push lower. And this is exactly how we confirm our reversal in this case. All right. First spike, initial spike, diamond is right here. And that's why we are actually attacking. And just a few candles later, we got the target. By the way, here it shows now after a few candles, and this is our Scorpio previously as well, together with the other ones. So that's pretty much all, guys, for this week. Do you have any questions? Is Tedros gonna go Vladimir Ivakov have different? Yes, they do. Traders Academy Club is a different website, so you need different ID there. If you have issues, please drop an email to the support. Thank you, Peter. All right, guys, so wishing you a wonderful weekend. Thank you for being here today with me and for the discussions and all the inputs. Enjoy. Reload the energies, and I'm going to catch you next week. All right, guys, bye for now.